Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the proposal of the new Getting Started Tiddler for empty HTML. There has been a discussion shortly in the Google groups where a user of TiddlyWiki created a nice blog post, which I can show here. It's on hackday.com. And there is a little introduction about TiddlyWiki and that he likes it. Yeah. And then there are some videos which are kind of old from 2015. But if we have a closer look, he created three videos with about 45 minutes just to create the table of contents and a basic to-do application. And in reality, it shouldn't be that complicated. It should be, I don't know, a task for 2 minutes, self-explaining, and it shouldn't need 1 hour of it. So the new Getting Started page is an attempt to make this stuff easier. So we have Getting Started that everyone knows, and then there are some more options. So it says show home button. Then there is a checkbox. If the user checks this checkbox, then the home button is added. And as the button is added, then there is some additional information. So at the very beginning, there is just a little bit of information. And when the user goes on, the information expands. So there it says, okay, there can be more information. The right sidebar in the tools tab. So if you click it here, so user knows, okay, there is a lot more possibilities and they can play with it. Next point is show the journal button. Journal button appears. And then it says there is more information about the journal and new Tiddler options that can be found in the control panel Info Basics tab. So there is the same icon as used here in the page icons, so the user can make the connection between these icons. If he clicks it, then we can see, okay, there is more information about new Tiddler or new journals. Text and okay, so that's the connection between or to the control panel. And then there is a new button which creates the new contents tab. So if I check it, I get the contents tab. Then there is some information. The tag of the table of content is table of content. And then there is a button, so the user can create a button with the right tag. So click it, say okay. Now this new Tiddler is part of the contents tab. Then there is some more information. So check this box if you want to have a new here in the Tiddler toolbar. So we check it. So now we get this information. So and if I say new here, then I can create structure in the table of content. And these are the basic steps which are needed. If the user knows the basics, then they can go on. If I create the new Tiddler and I have a second one, the basic root structure, and if the Tiddler, if the user opens it, then they see, okay, it has the tag table of content. So that's table of content. Then many users want to have a small to-do task application. So we create one. With a click here, it creates new Tiddler, which is named task. It is also a tagged table of contents. So it shows here. And then there is a new task button, which creates a new Tiddler. I say OK, then I can see it here. So the problem now is that it jumps all the time. If I create a new Tiddler, it automatically opens the Tiddler. That's why here is a add tags to the right sidebar, or add tab tasks to the right sidebar. So I open here, I say new task. A new task. B. And so on, yeah. And now we have a nice little to-do list application, which is part of the right sidebar. There is also the drag and drop possibility, yeah. And if the user wants to get more information about how this works, then we say, okay, more info can be found at TiddlyWiki.com. If I open it, then it gets the information about list tagged draggable macro. This example. Yeah, and that's basically it. And I think this is a, I don't know, 5-minute video. Yeah, and with the click of some buttons, we have the table of contents introduced, we have a task list introduced, and a little bit of an overview so that the user can start to work. I think that should be the way to go. Have fun.